Good day to all of you. Myself, Faravinder, HRT College in Kalpakkam. Today, I am going to demonstrate in practically how to do the tapping operation. In other words, we can call it internal threading. First, I will be explaining about the tools. What are the tools we are using on the tapping operation? Second, on the procedure of threading, not only for tapping, what are the procedure we are following in a normally threading operation, then practical video. Tapping is the process to make an internal thread. Now, for that one, we are using on the major tool, it is called a tap. And other one, it is called the supporting tool, is called a tap wrench. Tap wrench, we have a different is there. Tap also, we have a different tap are available. Let's see the parts of the tap: tang, shank, flute, etc. Now you can see the picture. This is we called a tap wrench. Tap wrench is the supporting tool for the tapping, and one of the handle is adjustable and one is the fixed handle. In the tap, tang portion is accommodated to the tap wrench inside. We don't use on the shank part especially. So this is we called a tap wrench. This one it is called a T type tap wrench or T handle tap wrench. For the small size of tap, we are using this one. Now the important one, this is we to demonstrate M12 threading. So in a set of M12 threading tap, in a set of M12 tap, we have a three different type of tap are is there. Three are in the same size. Technically we called the first tap, second tap and third tap. The name of first tap is called tapper tap, plug tap or intermediate tap and bottoming tap. Let's see how we identify the tap is there important. Whenever we go for the threading operation, tapping operation, first we will be started with the tapper tap and then we are applying on the plug tap. Finally, we are using on the bottoming tap. Let's see how do you identify the different type of tap is there. Now you can see the first tap, the bottom side, they have a more taper, or the ratio of taper will be coming 8 to 10 is there. See in the picture you can see the this is only first taper. Whenever you go for the tapping, this is the first taper. This is equal to your minor die of your thread, and this tap only easily go for your drill bolt. And second one, it is called plug tap. Plug tap, you can see there is a bottom side, they have a 3 to 5 thread are chamfered ratio, and bottoming tap. Bottoming tap means you can see the finishing tap or bottom tap, they have a 1 or 2 thread are tapped is there. So you familiar with when you going for the threading, first upon we need to follow the sum of the criteria. It is very important. Doesn't mean for the tapping operation, if you go for any threading operation, it is internal or external or by hand or by machine, we need to follow the criteria. First criteria, you need to find out your thread is the right hand or left hand or tap thread. You can see in this picture there is a one thread is right hand and other one is the left hand is there. See that other picture also, right hand thread in other form, always right side will be up and left side will be down, and left hand thread will be left side up and right side will be down. So these are the thread we are using for the some different purpose. For example, your cycle pedal, grinding machine, etc. we are using on the left hand. In a contact class I will be explaining you. And next one it is called taper thread. So this is also one of the things very comfortable for the high pressure area or ceiling wise we are using on the taper thread. Now see, first important things, you need to identify what hand of your thread. So today we are selected our thread is a right hand. Now second criteria, your form of the thread. You can see there are different type of thread is there. In other words, we can say the shape of the thread. Now see, most of them see the V shape of the thread, and there are so many other standard is there. Each of the form will be indicated to the purpose of use wise and etc. Each of the thread have a, there are different angle is there and different depth is there. I am not going to more about that depth. I'll explain now you what are the different form of thread. So first one it is called V thread, and this is we called a metric thread. Metric thread we are selecting today. Metric thread angle will be 60 degree, depth will be coming 0.61p, 614p. It is a standard wise, and you can see there are so many different forms like a PSW, Whitworth standard thread, American international thread, ESF, square thread, knuckle thread, etc. Now you can see other picture is there. Why form is important? Because your tap, if you consider in a hand tool, this is already made in a V shape or other according to your form of the thread. You don't want to much more worry about it. But if you are going for the machining threading, you need to grind your tool according to the form of your thread. For example, if you are going to do the metric thread, then your tool angle also you need to maintain in the V shape according to the standard form of the things. You can see in this picture there is a V threader doing with the thread. So I hope all of you understood the form of the thread or shape of the thread according to you need to maintain your tool. In the tapping operation, for the hand tapping, it will be already made with the tools. Now, standard and size, in according to IS, international standard, very important. Each and every thread, they have a standard size either. Today, we are selected metric thread. Now, you can see my thread size is a M12 and 1.75 is the pitch. Now, anywhere in the world where you go for metric M12 thread, the pitch of the thread will be 1.75. There are other pitches there, 1.5 and 1.25. There are so many other standards like a British standard, Whitworth, UNF, UNC, etc. etc. So, standard also one of the important criteria for the threading. Now, next one, you can see the size of the thread. Now, I said today we are going to demonstrate a M12 into 1.75 thread. Anywhere, if you go for each of the letter will be indicated 1.15. You can see here it is on the sideways. There is a picture is there. What is the thread, parts of the thread? The M letter is indicated the metric standard, and the 12 is indicated major dia of the thread. And 1.75 is indicated pitch of the thread. Very important, you need to find out the size of the thread, because if you are going for the tapping, there is a first operation we called TDS. Coming slide I will be showing you. So the size according to this, everybody know what is pitch, what is major dia and root, everything this is important. Now the major factor, when you go for the tapping operation, first things you need to do a drilling. Without drilling, you cannot do for the tapping because it is internal threading. Now, tapping operation, first things we need to find out the TDS. What is TDS? Tap drill size. Okay, according to your thread size. Today, your selected thread is M12 into 1.75. Now, first mistake, whenever we go for 12 mm size of thread, major dia of thread, never ever do the drilling in a 12 mm. Then, you need to find out the drill bit size. There is a small formula is there. So according to the metric thread, major dia minus pitch, it is the standard formula for the threading for the metric. So we can apply on the formula. TDS is equal to 12 subtract 1.75 mm. Then you can get the size of the drill bit size 10.25. So you can get, this is the size of your drill bit. Suppose you don't get a 10.25, you can consider 10.2 or 10.3 number. And also, suppose you don't know what is the size of your TDS, then you can look at on the steel rule backside, there is a conversion table is there. This is a standard drill bit table is there. You can download from the Google. I hope all of you understood what are the different type of tapping tool and how to do the threading. What are the criteria we have to follow for the threading, etc. Now see the practically how to do the tapping operation. Let's watch how to do in the tapping operation. So we have a three taps are there. Earlier I explained first tap, second tap, third tap. Now you look at on there. In that one, any other tap, except the first tap. For example, you can see my piece of work is there. Okay, already I done the drilling according to the my thread size. So earlier I explained the TDS size. 10.25 is there. Now
if I going for the tapping operation, if I use the any other tap, for example, right now I choose the third tap or finishing tap, it will not match into the hole. So what we have to do? So there is something mistake. So again I used on the second tap also. If I used on there, it will not going to match second tap. If I used on the second tap also, it will not matching on the hole. Okay, the reason is there. Your TDS size equal to the bottom side of your first tap. Bottom side of your first tap. Now look at on there. My first tap. Tap. If I fix it on your drilled hole, it will be absolutely matching on there. So basically, when you are going for the hand tapping operation, first you need to select on the tap and match it on there. One thing especially you need to remember, the size of the thread, if M12 means according to you find out the TDS, then choose the drill bit, do the drilling. After that only you can go for the thread. If the size are slightly above or below, the tapping may be go to the wrong process. I select on the tap wrench. And you can see tap wrench, I already explained, one hand is adjusted. This part we call the tang. Tang must be go to inside of the tap wrench. You can see I just fixed in there. You can see close watch on there. If you see here, I am not fixed fully. I show you basically all the boys are doing one mistake only. If you fixed here, it is absolutely wrong. They maybe get the slip. So which area I need to select? Only this much of area. This part we called tang. Tang part must be matched to your tap wrench. And tight, hand tight is more than sufficient. Just give a tight it on there. And one more important thing, during the threading time, always you need to use on the lubrication. It is compulsory. Any cutting tool we are using, a proper method, and I am using on there. First, you have to fix it on there. Okay, one thing you have to remember, whenever you have to go for the hand tapping, you can see it is not okay matched properly. First one, you need to do the starter thread. Starter thread means a gripping process. Any thread, external or internal tapping, first you have to fix it on the tap and just give a press on there. Then you have to give a tapping, 1, 2, 3. Again I said 1, 2, 3. You have to grip on there, then aligned on the tap, it is tap angle is correct or not, then you have to start on the threading. Rules number one, whenever you go for the tapping, safety, okay, safe working practice. First one, you match the tapping properly, starter thread with the first tap. Then you need to rotate one complete circle, then half of the circle must be back. This compulsory, it is you need to apply the lubrication. Lubrication, just you need to apply the lubrication on the flute of the area. In a drop by drop, you can apply on there. Just you have to do the drop by drop, you have to apply, then start to the threading. So once we are doing on the tapping, okay, remember one thing, sir, starting thread, the end of the process, you can see the bottom side, I said the tap head side, and upside actually the M12 size, you need to do the tapping up to the top of the side, then only tapping will be completed. Actually this is a first process, only 25% of the tap only done. Now once I entered, I need to remove it back. Once we finished on the first tap, now if we removed, okay, most of the person will be doing one mistake. Never ever clean the tap by your hand. First mistake, rush and clean the tap neatly within safety. Now first process I did on the first tap. Now we are going for the second tap. Choose the second tap, same process, adjust the handle and fix it in proper method. Now you don't want to give a pressure on the second tap. Match the pitch. Just match the pitch on the thread. Then start to same process. Before doing, you need to apply just a lubrication. Same process we need to continue until the end of there. If you completed on the second tap fully, okay, threading, your threading operation will be completed more than 95%. Basically we are using on the first tap and second tap, that is more than enough to for the hand tapping. Now going for blind tapping and all the things we have to do. Blind hole tapping, we have to do the tap tapping. So, Now we are going to do the third tapping or finishing tap. Same operation, just do third tap, same operation. If you completed on there, your tapping will be finished. Compared to first tap, second tap, your third tap will be very easy to do it. Guys, we complete the process. Clean on the top of the surface with a brush. After that, one thing you have to clearly look at. You can see the tapping is done. And here it is, this area it is, there is a excess metal is there. Okay, we called burr. Okay, this burr you need to file it or just grind it and remove. Inside the thread also you need to clean with any type of cloth. Your tapping operation will be completed. Once you completed on the tapping operation, you need to check it with your tapping is done, is correct or not. Okay, basically we are using on the screw pitch gauge. You can find it on there. But ultimately we need to show our end product is right or wrong with your anywhere in the fascination. Now look, I have a bolt is there. It is M12 size. Use on the bolt. Thank you very much. Okay, if you have any practical related query or regarding tapping query, you can comment it on comment box. Okay, have a good day. Thank you very much.